Hello everyone. I'd like to talk to you about global variables. A global variable is any variable that can be used by a function within a class without having to instantiate it or creating an object out of it. Okay, so any function can use it at any time and can change its value or use it in any of the functions within that class. So I have a couple of global variables set up, and if we look here, I've got one here and here, and how we do it is we actually set up like we do any other variable. So here's our data type, variable name, and I'm giving an initial value of 0. Down here I've got one, string, variable name, getting an initial value of n. Now the only thing that's different is I'm using the keyword here of static. Okay, and basically static says that any function can use that. You do not have to instantiate that as an object. So any function can use it at any time. So this is where we have our global variables. And you'll notice it's within the class. So here's the start of our class. And I've got a function right here starting. So as long as it's not in a function, but still within the class, that's where I can define my global variable. I do want to point out here, I can also do that with a scanner. I've got a scanner set up. So I've got a scanner called my scanner, new scanner system in. And if I want to have it so that any of the functions can use that, then I just basically put static and I put it in the same spot, sort of in this area here, still within the class, but not within a function. Okay, so now let's just take a look at our handy dandy little functions to demonstrate this. What I've got going on here, we've got a static void my function one, and it's basically just asking for a number. And I'm wrapping this in a try and catch. So I've asked for a number here, my scanner next line, gonna parse it to a double because that's our data type, and then store it into my global variable, my number. And then I'm going to show it that my number was changed. So I've got a systemout.println showing that function one changed the value of my global variable. And then I set this up in a try and catch. So just in case somebody decided to put a letter in or some word or something like that, we won't crash the program. Now if we look a little farther down, function 2 is doing the very same thing. Once again, it's the very same function, okay, but it's a different, you know, a different function. It's function 2, okay, but we're doing the very same thing, asking for a number, parsing it to a double, storing it in our global variable, and then we're showing that my number was changed by function 2. Once again, I've set this up in a try and catch, just in case somebody tried to put something in there that wasn't a number or couldn't be parsed to a double. And if we look here at function 3, it does the very same thing. So I've got three different functions that can change the value of my global variable, my number. Okay, pretty cool stuff. Now just to sort of flush this out, I did put a simple menu system with it. So if we go ahead and look here, I got a little menu system going on. So here's my menu function. Okay, I've initialized a choice. So I've got it saying here, hey, pick function 1, 2, or 3. Please enter a choice. I've got it set up in a try and catch. So just in case they decide to put a letter in there or a word, we're catching that. And instead of causing the program to crash, I'm arbitrarily going to assign it to a choice value of 4. Okay, and then we're going to flip that down into our switch statement. So I've got a switch statement going on. So here's choice. So if choice is 1, we're going to call function 1. If choice is 2, we're going to call function 2. Choice is 3, call function 3. Otherwise, if they pick anything else, you just say that wasn't a choice. And then let's look at our main function. So our static void main, I've got this in a while statement. And if you notice here, I am checking for the false. So if the false is true, we're going to run this. So I says, well, quit, if quit equals y, okay, but here's the not. Okay, so as long as we're not clicking y, we will actually run our loop. So we're going to here call my menu. It goes up, runs any of the choices, functions 1, 2, or 3, comes back out, ask if we'd like to quit. If I pick anything but a y, we're going to store it in here. If I do put a y in here, does y not equal y? No, it does equal y. So if I put a y in there, that would make that false. That kicks us out, and then we're out. We exit. So that's our handy dandy little program to demonstrate this. So what I want to show you then is the actual program in operation up here. So I'll go ahead and I'll run it. So over here, there's my menu. It says, please enter a choice. I'm going to pick one. Please enter a number, 22. Okay, so that function actually changed the value of our global variable to 22. Okay, would I like to quit? No. I'll pick function 3. Please enter a number. Once again now, function 3 changed the value of that global variable to 44. Would I like to quit? Yes. And we're out. So, let's just go back to the top. Here's our global variable, my number. We can define our variables up in here. And they're very powerful. So, as we can saw, the different functions can change its value. So they can be used by the different functions real easy. But the downside of that is any of those functions can also change that value. So you have to be real careful on what's changing the value of my number. Okay, so because of that, you want to use your global variables very sparingly. Okay, so you shouldn't set up all your variables as a global variable. That's very bad form. But having one or two that you may need to be share, that's values between multiple different functions, that's okay. So use them sparingly, and they can be very, very helpful. And that concludes my little talk on global variables.